Welcome to the lecture on Unijunction Transistor Relaxation Oscillator. In this lecture, we are going to see some basics regarding the UJT and its application as relaxation oscillator and frequency of oscillation of the relaxation oscillator. Unijunction Transistor. Unijunction transistor is a three-terminal semiconductor device which exhibits negative resistance and switching characteristics for use as a relaxation oscillator in phase control applications. It has three terminals, emitter, base 1 and base 2. The basic structure of UJT. This is the basic structure. It consists of a lightly doped N-type silicon bar with a heavily doped P-type material alloyed to its one side closer to B2 for producing a single PN junction. As it has only one PN junction and three leads, it is commonly called as unijunction transistor. Equivalent circuit of UJT. This is the equivalent circuit of UJT, which consists of a diode and two resistances RB1 and RB2. This diode is equivalent of the PN junction which we have seen in the previous slide. The interbase resistance between the base 1 and base 2 of the silicon bar is RBB, which is the summation of RB1 and RB2. With emitter terminal open, if voltage VBB is applied between the two bases, a voltage gradient is established along the N-type bar. The voltage drop across RB1 is V1, which is equal to eta into VBB, where eta is the intrinsic standoff ratio, which is given by RB1 by RB1 plus RB2. The typical value of the intrinsic standoff ratio is 0.56 to 0.75. The characteristics of UJT. As we have seen that with the emitter open, if the voltage VBB is applied, a voltage drop V1 occurs across this RB1, and this voltage V1 reverse biases this PN junction and the emitter current is cut off. So now when the UJT will turn on? So it will turn on if a positive voltage VE is applied to the emitter. The applied voltage should exceed V1 by the cutting voltage of the diode. Then only it will become forward biased and the emitter current increases and the device will be in on state. If a negative voltage is applied, then the PN junction will remain reverse biased and the emitter current is cut off and the device will be in the on state. So now we will move on to the application of UJT as a UJT relaxation oscillator. Now what is a relaxation oscillator? A relaxation oscillator using UJT produces sawtooth waveforms. This is the circuit diagram of UJT relaxation oscillator. It consists of an UJT, a capacitor CE, which is charged through the resistance RE. When the supply voltage VBB is switched on, the voltage across the capacitor increases exponentially. When it reaches the peak point voltage VP. Now what is VP? VP is eta VBB plus V gamma, where V gamma is the cutting voltage of the diode. If the voltage across the capacitor reaches this VP, then the UJT starts conducting and the capacitor voltage is discharged rapidly through EB1 and R1. As the capacitor voltage reaches zero, the device then cuts off and the capacitor starts to charge again. This cycle is repeated continuously, generating a sawtooth waveform. So this is the output waveform where it is obtained across the capacitor CE. So we obtain this waveform due to the charging and discharging of this capacitor. So the charging path is from VBB through RE, CE and to the ground, and the discharging path is from CE, EB1 and R1. The inclusion of the external resistance R2 and R1 in series with B2 and B1 provides spike waveforms. When the UJT fires, the sudden surge of current through the B1 causes a voltage drop across R1, which provides positive going spikes, these spikes. Also, at the time of firing, the fall of VEB1 generates negative going spikes across R2. That is, when the capacitor voltage reaches the peak point voltage, it starts to discharge. Also, it turns on and starts to discharge. When it is turns on, due to that sudden surge of current through R1, this positive spikes are produced. At the same time, when it turns on, the drop of EB1 produces this spike. And this is the waveform which is taken across VB1, and this is the waveform taken across VB2, and this waveform is taken across the capacitor CE. By changing the value of the capacitor CE and the resistance RE, the frequency of the waveform can be changed. So now let us see an expression for the frequency of oscillation. Assume the capacitor is initially uncharged and the voltage VC prior to breakdown is VC equal to VBB into 1 minus e power minus t by RECE, where VC is the capacitor voltage, VBB is the DC voltage which has been applied, and RECE is the charging time constant and t is time from the commencement of the waveform. The discharge of the capacitor occurs when the capacitor voltage is equal to the peak voltage. So in that case, we can replace this VC by VP. Hence, equation 1 is changed to VP equal to VBB into 1 minus e power minus t by RECE. So now we already know an expression for VP. What is VP? VP is eta VBB plus V gamma. We can approximate this expression by neglecting V gamma. So VP can be considered as eta into VBB. So the expression changes to eta VBB equal to VBB into 1 minus e power minus t by RECE. Now this VB and this VB will get cancelled and the expression changes to this form. Now we can rearrange this expression by bringing this 1 to the left hand side. So 1 minus eta equal to e power minus t by RECE. So now what is our aim? Our aim is to obtain an expression for the frequency of oscillation, which means we should get an expression for this t. So we have to rearrange this expression. How can we rearrange this? Take logarithm on both sides and rearranging, we obtain the expression as t equal to RECE log to the base e 1 by 1 minus eta. So now if we change the base, that is if we change the base to 10, then the expression changes to t equal to 2.303 RECE log 10 1 by 1 minus eta. So now if the discharge time of the capacitor is neglected, that is, this is the waveform for which we are trying to find the frequency of oscillation. This is the charging time and this is the discharging time. So what is the total time period of this waveform t? T equal to capital T, t equal to t1 plus t2. So now this discharging time is very small, so we can neglect this t2 and we can approximate the time period of the waveform as t equal to t1. So now if the discharge time is neglected, then we can consider t equal to t1, which is equal to the total time period of the wave. Therefore, the frequency of oscillation of the sawtooth wave is f naught equal to 1 by t, 1 by is equal to 1 by 2.303 RECE log 10 to 1 by 1 minus eta. This expression is the frequency of oscillation of the sawtooth generator, whereas this expression, okay, this one, t equal to 2.303 RECE log 10 1 by 1 minus eta is the sweep time of the relaxation oscillator. Thank you for listening this lecture.